man in the number six position, Jari Puikkanen of Finland. Next out of the gate, the 24-year-old from Lahti. 103 and a half meters, his first jump. 100.1 points for the number six position. Now, if he can hit a big one here, if he can score about 96 points, he can take the lead from Armin Kogler of Austria in the second round. The overall lead. And it looks like he might do that. He's well over the skis, has a long jump. Good steady landing. We're going to need right at 96 points. 102 meters. 196.6. He goes into the lead by 1 point over Armin Kogler of Austria.
Chest is tight to the knees. Snap looked good. He's on quickly. Right there, he goes over into a nice position. Slight bend at the waist and good forward leg drive.
That is Greg Winsberger, the coach of the United States jumping team, and he is communicating with the jumper at the start gate. I talked with him earlier about how he effects that communication and where his information comes from and how he transmits it.
Yeah, we have kind of a sign language that we'll go through again tomorrow, kind of like a third base coach, you know, bunts and all that sort of thing. But I'll be on the takeoff of near the 70 meter, and I'll have one of our development coaches down below, and I'll have Erling up above, and they'll communicate to me how the wind is in each direction. Then I'll look at how it is directly for me, and I'll give them a sign one way or the other to hold off, to not come out into the start, to wait, or to it's ready to go.
You know, sometimes if you use 18 of those 20 seconds, it can be a heck of an advantage, Ken.
Oh, definitely. We found at one earlier competition this year, we just held it out to the very last second, and it really proved good for Jeff. That was at Lake Placid. Mm-hmm.
Next up, it is Michael Holland of the United States. Number 33. Michael had a 90-meter jump for 71.2 points his first time after the first round. He was in 40th position. Finished 41st in the 70-meter competition last weekend.
Mike's a very capable jumper, though, and during training has gone down well over 100 meters several times.
From Norwich, Vermont.
He approaches the takeoff at 60 miles an hour. Having a little problem with scissoring there, but pretty good distance. Good telemark landing. The judges like that.
Looked like the gust of wind may have caught him and twisted him just a little bit, but he comes up with a 96-meter jump. And his point total of 71.2, certainly not enough in that first effort to put him in medal contention, but he will finish with 154.8 points. Listen to the crowd come up for this one now. This is Vasya Pajic of Yugoslavia. 103 and a half meters, 99.6 points for him. He needs 97 plus to move into the lead ahead of Puikkanen of Finland. Kogler is right now in the number two spot. And Pajic will give it a try as the home folks roar.
Moved into the takeoff well. Looked like the skis came up off a quick though. That's going to cut his distance down.
Vasya Pajic of Yugoslavia looks back to the scoreboard. He's got 94 meters. He's 9.5 meters short of his first jump, but everybody's been a little shorter because they moved the starting gate down. And the point totals for Pajic after two jumps, 1.814. Now the Americans in this huge throng anticipating the appearance of Jeff Hastings. Earlier, I asked Jeff if he'd learned anything this week in training that might be of some help to him.
Seems like I'm always learning stuff, but I'm not getting any smarter. I've learned a lot, mostly, I guess, about myself and under stress and what I have to do and how I have to take an important competition. There haven't been any breakthroughs as far as ski jumping, physical ski jumping or anything, but still things have been learned.
What do you feel about these little dudes now, these 120-pounders? They get up there and stay up there like a dove.
They're good on the ski jumps, but they don't impress many people on the beaches, so that's where I've got them.
Still got his sense of humor. Ready to go, number 41 now, 102.5, 95.7 points in his first jump. I thought he was a little short in style points, but it's tough early in the day.
Jeff has a very strong takeoff, and if he hits it, he could do well. And he did. He's got tremendous height, and he's got good carry toward the end of the flight. A beautiful landing. This is going to put him in contention.
He knew full well that he had a good jump as he thrust his hand into the air and will turn now. Down at the out run and look back to see where he stands. The Hastings family waiting. Greg Winsberger waiting. It's 107 meters, 201.2 points, and that moves him past Kuikkanen and quite possibly into third place behind Nukkanen and Weissmuth when it's all done. Who knows? We may finally have another medal in Olympic ski jumping for the American side.
He really pounded the takeoff and moved quickly over his skis, and when Jeff's upper body is curled over the tips of those skis, that's when you know he has a good one going.
Just as still as you could be as he floated down 107 meters. A massive effort by Jeff Hastings.